This ninth aspect is called soul. That is what we call soul. The lowest seventh of this ninth aspect is called our soul, human soul. The soul of the soul that is working with the ego, individual soul. Though there is nothing like individual soul, soul is working with the individual. So if we make the ninth aspect into seven equal parts, the highest is the Sanat Kumara, the lowest is individual soul.
Mm-hmm.
And also there is another difference between these two. The ninth aspect belongs to the eternal. The ninth aspect, the soul, is eternal.
Eternal.
All the other eight are not eternal, they are periodical.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They come and go.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
In the secret doctrine, that is, in the stanzas of the book of Dhyan, it is said that the tenth one has his breath as the ninth, and he breathes out all the eight and breathes in all the eight. This is the inhalation and exhalation of the whole cosmos. When he breathes out, this is all the creation, the day of Brahma, a creator. When he breathes in, this is called the night of Brahma.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is how the secret act introduces these things to us. So the whole thing is eternally periodical. That is what Blavatsky gives in the secret act. The whole thing is eternally periodical, because the periodicity goes on continuously. The coming out and going in, coming out, going in, it has no beginning and no ending. But every universe has its own beginning and its own ending. Like that. These eight exist with the not self in you. In the matter, the mind and the senses, they form, these eight form the not self in you. And they do not exist with the real self. Therefore, these eight are called untruth in the scriptures. Untruth. It is not false, but it is untruth. The double negative is used. Untruth. And the two put together, the Veda says, truth and untruth put together forms the capsule of truth. Truth and untruth put together forms one capsule of truth, one unit of truth. That is what the Veda says.
But this is interesting, because if you put for truth plus,
yes,
and for untruth minus, and if you put together in the mathematics, then this is minus.
Yes.
And here is the plus.
Here it is plus.
Yeah. Well, this is interesting.
Yes. You can say like this.
Yes. It's wild.
Because this is the whole truth of everything. Creation, dissolution, everything.
Mm.
This is the whole truth. Therefore it is plus.
I see. It's a little abstract. Huh? In the relation with the mathematics.
Hmm? Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah?
So, the eight aspects of nature we have given, the three qualities we have given, the three qualities apply to the eight aspects, and not the ninth aspect we have given. The ninth also is called in some scriptures, especially in the scripture of the Chaldeans and the Hebrews, it is called the virgin. The virgin. This is called the virgin nature.
The virgin nature. What virgin. Is it?
Yeah, the unbelievable. It is also called the mother nature. Mother, virgin mother. It is called the virgin mother. And the author of Bhagavad Gita, the compiler, who has made the book, you know, Veda Vyasa.
Vyasa?
Vyasa.
This is the name. He lived millions of years ago.
No, 5,000 years ago.
5,000?
Yes.
This was Vyasa, millions years ago.
Vyasa. This is Veda Vyasa, the contemporary of Krishna. And he lived 5,000, there are calculations, astronomical, because he has given the astronomical constellations during his time. Mm. About 5,000 years ago he lived. Mm. And he has compiled this book, Bhagavad Gita. And he calls himself the son of the truth-bearing virgin. That is what he is called. The son of the truth-bearing virgin.
Bearing.
Just as child-bearing, this is truth-bearing virgin. Mm-hmm. In Sanskrit, Satyavati means truth-bearing. Mm-hmm. He calls himself the son of Satyavati, the virgin. Mm.